welcome to the show. You're here with me, Amaya, on a brand new Thursday morning. It's the 7th of August, 2014. And of course, the year is just flying by. But these days, I'm actually very, very glad to be out of the house because right now my brother is sitting for his advanced level examination, which means that there is a bit of a stressful scenario going on in my house. He's not stressed out. My mother is stressed out and causing a lot of stress for the rest of us as well. So it's a bit of a battlefield there. So I'm very happy to be here on this sofa and be here with you this morning. But I'm sure that many of you, even as students, as parents, go through the same scenario as well. The local examination started just this week on Monday, and of course the London A-level results are going to be coming out soon as well, and the EZ scores for last year's local advanced level examination coming out at the same time. So many things happening at a crucial juncture for all students who are here in Sri Lanka, whether you did local A-levels or London A-levels. It's time to make a decision about the future. But when it comes to that, there are so many choices out there, so many new information, so much new information coming in through sources such as the internet and relatives, the school. There's so many things to process at the same time. So how do you sort all of this out in your head, and how do you make sense and make the correct choice for your future? One that you won't regret when you're halfway through a particular degree program, and one that you can make sure that you can stick with for the rest of your life. Because choosing a career at, you know, at 18 years of age or 19 years of age is not an easy thing to do. And it's very important to have the right information at your fingertips. So on that note, I'm not going to be giving you that information. We have professionals from the field who are here with us to share their knowledge. They've been in the field for many, many years now, giving opportunities to students here in Sri Lanka. And they're here with us on the show this morning to speak about a new venture that's going to, I think, put a lot of parents as well as students' minds at ease when it comes to their future. So we have with us on the show this morning representatives from Aspirations Education, and we have Mrs. Deepamala Abhesekara. She is Miss Deepamala Abhesekara, and she is the Managing Director of Aspirations Education. Morning.
Morning.
You were here with us on the show earlier, and I think I made the same mistake.
Yes, you keep making the same mistake.
I'm so very sorry. But it's great to fine. See you again.
Yeah, lovely to see you
morning.
Again.
Yes, and I'm going to speak about something new. And you have along with you Dr. Induvara Veerakkodi. He is a consultant with Aspirations as well, and he's here to speak about this new venture. So thank you for being with us, Doctor.
Yes,
and I should mention that he's a medical doctor, so on that, along those lines, he's here to speak about something very relevant. And that is this new concept that you have launched called the Aspirations World of Medicine. So let's hear about this, Deepamala. What exactly is the purpose behind this?
Yes, Amaya. Now, like you gave the introduction, for the students after A-levels and O-levels, they're at a crucial juncture, and the parents have a lot of problem deciding what exactly their daughter or son wants to do. And on that note, we have been guiding a lot of students who want to do medicine and pursue studies in medical science. And at the same time, we have been working with a network of more than 100 universities and 100 universities plus institutes over the world, including Australia, Malaysia, Singapore, then China, India, a variety of countries. Mm-hmm. And we have also been guiding many students to study medicine abroad, and we have medical colleges which are highly reputed in countries such as India, China, Malaysia, and Australia and UK. Mm-hmm. So it just made sense for us to sort of package our guidance in a way that we can really help the students out there who want to study medicine, because medicine is in so much demand, and we really feel that we have to give the necessary guidance mm-hmm. to the students who are pursuing a career which is as demanding and extremely responsible. You have to take a massive responsibility to be a doctor. So we thought our guidance is extremely necessary, and therefore we're planning to inaugurate and launch our career guidance, which we have been doing for the past 10 years, and reshape it, focusing on medicine and opening a new sort of a niche for medical studies. And that is called Your World of Medicine, presented to you by Aspirations Education. And we hope that we can do a fantastic service mm-hmm. to the students who want to pursue their studies in medicine.
Of course. And I'm sure there are so many factors that you have to consider when choosing this profession, because although the traditional, you know, doctor, lawyer, engineer formula is not really there anymore, there are people who are going pursuing a lot of different opportunities as well. It's still a career that's very, very in demand. And it's something that I think a lot of students in Sri Lanka look for. But there are so many places to look at and so many factors to consider. So let's speak about some of the factors that you should consider when it comes to selecting a medical university. Doctor?
Yeah. Well, Amaya, there are so many different factors that you should consider when selecting a medical school and a medical career. I'll first start with the factors you should consider when selecting a medical school before talking about the other factors, because it's a separate topic we need to talk about, very important. But when you're selecting a medical school, first you need to check whether they are properly registered with the Sri Lanka Medical Council. That's the most important factor, because we have met some students who have decided on a school and they have decided that they should study abroad in a foreign country and to come back and practice in Sri Lanka, but they have forgot to check the medical council registration. So there are instances like that. So it's really important to check whether that particular university is registered with the SLMC. Secondly, it's so important to understand the quality of the training that they will be getting in the university. For an example, in some countries the diseases and the patterns of diseases are different. So you should, when you select a country or a particular medical school for medical training, it's so important to look at the quality of clinical exposure. So you will be getting a hospital training in any medical school anyway. But even more than the theory, the clinical exposure is very important. So you should look at what kind of training that you're getting. And also, you should look at the financial factors, like for an example, when a student is selecting a university, that can be the best university in the world, but you should be able to afford it. So maybe you have good results, you're eligible to go, but still you should look at the financial affordability, because there are good degrees, good universities which offer degrees at a very affordable rate. And again, finally, you should look at eligibility. That is, you should have, you know, minimum educational qualifications and all sorts of other qualifications to get selected. So without looking at these factors, students can, you know, cannot go into medical studies. And it's a very important, you know, thing to analyze and to understand, you know, what factors to consider when choosing the medical school, even before they apply. So
that's a long list of factors, then. It's very important. I mean, you can't emphasize enough the fact that all of these factors are very important to look into. But again, a student might be lost when it comes to, you know, what's the process? What's the procedure? Where do I start? These questions might pop up. So does aspirations come in at that point, Deepamala?
Yes, exactly. Now, Amaya, like Doctor explained, it's about finding the right university that matches all these requirements. And the list looks exhaustive and it looks a bit long and daunting as well. But this is where aspirations come, because we have done that background check. And we would not represent universities that are not recognized by the Sri Lankan Medical Council. And if a university is not recognized, then if it offers an exceptional curricula in the sense of offering the program, then at a point like that, we have visited the university, like for the example, China Medical University at the point, which was recognized before by the Sri Lanka Medical Council. And we worked with them to get the recognition from the Sri Lanka Medical Council. And also that is because, like Doctor mentioned, we need to offer a variety of fee and course ranges as well, in the sense that some students can't afford studying medicine in a country like Australia or UK, because it's very expensive. But China offers it as a very quality education at a lesser affordable rate. Similarly, we have Manipal University, which is a very big brand, and a lot of our students do go to Manipal, India, and Manipal, Nepal. And now the good news is Aspirations Education is representing Malacca, Manipal, where the students can study 2 years in India, in Manipal and then transfer to Malacca in Malaysia and study another 2 years. So it's like they're getting the best of both worlds, studying in India and getting the clinical practices in Malaysia as well. Mm-hmm. And this comes to the course fee and the living cost all together for the 5 years comes to around 15 to 18 million, which is very much less compared to a cost that you might have to incur in Australia or UK.
Oh,
so on the other hand, China would be around 5 million for the whole years, mm-hmm. like the 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And also in the your world of aspirations for medicine, we also have not only Malaysia and Malacca, Manipal and China Medical University, but we also have a variety of highly reputed universities in Australia. Like
Dirumala, I think I'll have to interrupt you there.
Yes.
We're going for a very short break.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I think after we come back from
Definitely.
The break, you'll hear about all the reputed
yes.
Universities that are associated with Aspirations Education. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Good Morning Sri Lanka.
Are you proud of how far your business has come this year? Let your efforts be recognized at the National Business Excellence Awards 2014. Applications are now available at the National Chamber of Commerce of Sri Lanka. Organizer, the National Chamber of Commerce of Sri Lanka, number 450, Dr. Vijayavardhana Mavata, Colombo 10. Call 0114 741 984 or 071 90 70 700.
Aspirations International Education Exhibition, Monash, UNSW, University of South Australia, Western Sydney, Canberra, Curtin, Deakin, Swinburne, Bond, Nottingham and many more will be there. So be there. 5th, 6th July, Tad Samudra.
By Lambo, by Enrique Iglesias.
Do another please. Because I'm in it, baby girl. Got me feeling like I'm flying like I'm out in space. Something about your body says, come and take me. Got me hoping that the night don't stop.
Rock that body, come and don't stop.
Bailando, bailando, bailando.
To activate this song as your ringtone, contact your mobile operator.
Pop on Saturday, so Saturday night movie at 9:30 p.m.
So. Is coming to the big screen.
Enjoying third grade, I think you may be here a while.
And if you think you know Ramona, get ready to see her in a whole new light.
You don't worry about coloring inside the lines.
Ninth August, Ramona and Beezus.
You ready?
One, two!
Experts who have taken their companies to the next level.
We wanted to create certain wealth, preserve confidentiality,
good governance,
of a lot of hard work in different stages,
do some difference with the knowledge,
willing to take that quantum leap,
looking at the processes and the motivations and benefits,
to stay ahead of the game, going public.
Adventurous Sunday Kids movie at 8 a.m.
I'm placing an ad for a housekeeper.
Housekeeper?
Hello? Euphigenia, don't fire.
You look like a lady.
I'd love to get reacquainted.
Is never done.
10th August, Mrs. Doubtfire.
I'm getting hot flashes.
Cart Fever is back. This August, they face off on a race. Finish line. Fall 10th of August, Sri Lanka Karting Circuit, Bandaragama, 7:30 a.m. onwards.
Welcome back to the show. Now, if you did miss the first segment, you should know that we have with us the Managing Director of Aspirations Education, Ms. Deepamala Abesekara, as well as Medical Doctor, Dr. Induvara Veerakkodi. And they've been here to introduce a brand new concept that will really, really help Sri Lankan students, and that's called Your World of Medicine, now the Aspirations World of Medicine. And it's something that is here to help Sri Lankan students really reach their potential and fulfill their dreams when it comes to pursuing a career in medicine. And I think it's some with a career where lots of you might have a lot of problems. So we discussed some of the things that you should consider, the factors that you should consider when choosing medicine as a career. And Deepamala, you were saying about how aspirations can help the students when it comes to fulfilling this dream.
I was just giving you a list of universities and in different countries. So what I couldn't mention was the International Medical University, IMU in Malaysia.
That's popular, even I've heard of that.
Yes, it's also like Manipal is another brand, IMU is another brand, and IMU also has pathways to Australia and UK and Ireland and Canada and so on. So we directly represent University of New South Wales and Australian National University, like the one of the most prestigious university for the graduate entry. It's in Monash, Malaysia, Monash, Australia, University of Western Sydney and University of New South Wales. So all these universities, the medical faculties, this is what we represent in the Your World of Aspirations. Mm-hmm. And a special mention has to go about Manipal Melaka, because I think students will find studying in India in Manipal 2 years and Malaysia 2 years very exciting as well.
Yes, because there is a sort of, you know, cultural crossover there as well. It's not just one country that you're in.
Exactly.
Are there advantages to studying both in India and Malaysia?
Correct.
And let's speak about now when it comes to choosing. Now, lots of people, when they're, you know, 5 years old, their parents might be doctors. They might have heard about a career in medicine, you know, how great it is. What a great service it is, actually, to be a doctor and to help so many people and to save lives. So that can be a dream for so many people. But how can you be sure that medicine is actually for you, that that's the career that you should pursue? I mean, it is a long-term career. Once you are a doctor, you're a doctor. So how does the student know that it's the right choice to make?
Well,
doctor, now you made that choice. I'm sure you're happy with it.
That's a very important question. Actually, it's not a good time to ask that question when you're halfway through your career. So I think everybody who is planning to become a doctor should ask that question before they become a doctor. And in my case, I asked that question when I was a medical student, probably in my third year, because, you know, and a lot of my colleagues and a lot of people that I have met in my lifetime in the medical field had not asked that question before they entered medical career. They did not know what it would be like to become a doctor, what would be the life of a doctor.
Because you study a lot, you study, you know, that's all you do for at least 2 or 3 years to get into that career.
Exactly. So it's a lot of commitment. Mm-hmm. So it's really important to understand what it takes to become a doctor and also to understand whether it is actually for you, because it is not for everybody. And some say it's like the priesthood. So it's not exactly for people who are looking only for prestige or for money or something else. So there are a lot of factors to consider when identifying whether you are for medicine. And in Aspirations Education, in your world of medicine, there are tools and techniques developed to identify and to help people identify their own career, and one of the careers is medicine. So obviously it will be very helpful for me to explain the basis of that. So first thing, we use a technique called the three circle strategy at Aspirations. What we do is we try to find where all your strengths overlap. So in medicine, choosing medicine, it's as a career, it's very important. One circle would be your ability. So there are specific tools to identify your abilities. And the other circle would be your passion. And there is another circle which brings opportunities. So where ability and passion and opportunities overlap will be your career. So obviously for medicine, when you talk about abilities, the doctor is a person who's very analytical because it's a scientific thing. You need to analyze and to identify the problems and to give a solution. We need students who are very analytical and also not only analytical but also very compassionate and someone with a lot of people skills.
Oh, I see.
And not only that, you need to have the ability to absorb a lot of information because there are so much of so big volumes of information you need to retain. You will be information walking information reservoir basically as a doctor. So all three things you know combined into one will make a proper doctor. So those abilities are very very much required to even to decide to become one. And the other important circle is your passion. So you should have a genuine passion to become a doctor, and also opportunities in the sense the opportunities inside medicine would be fields or areas which makes you grow and which makes you somebody who would contribute to the world in a proper way. So the opportunity circle is a very important one. So we try to find students within these overlapping areas to make sure that they are very suitable for medicine and to help them to understand whether they are suitable. So there are, you know, long list of techniques and tools. I'm not going to mention them, but they are used to identify a person's personality and his or her own strengths to make sure that, you know, we are helping them to understand what medicine is and to help them to study better and to become a better doctor. So I'll give you a small example of something that happened very recently. At Aspirations, we met one student who came to us after completing his final MBBS exam.
And so he was a fully qualified
doctor?
He
was a fully qualified doctor.
Okay.
But his problem was he was very good in studies and he has completed all the exams very well. But he wanted to do engineering as a subject, and he wanted to become an engineer now. It was a very, you know, awkward, you know, scenario because, you know, you're a doctor now and you want to become an engineer. It's a completely different career and he's ready to choose that.
So and what this is after maybe like
five or six years of medical career, medicine, studying medicine. So we did a complete personality test and we had a long interview with him and later to understand from the personality tests that his career choice would be engineer, not doctor. It's more technical. And that is why he himself came up with the choice of becoming an engineer. But once you're a doctor, it takes another four or five years to become another engineer, and you know you're changing professions. Maybe if he doesn't like that at the end of the course, then he has to change it again. So luckily he found an area which overlaps with engineering and medicine. So later he decided to go ahead with that. He went to another country to study a postgraduate degree in biomedical engineering.
Oh,
and it was his medical qualification was a pre-qualification. So the example, I gave that example because there are a lot of students who are trying to become a doctor for a particular reason. But if you do these preliminary tests, you're avoiding a future mistake, a mistake that you will regret later. So you might choose a career which might be an overlap between medicine and something else. Or maybe you will find a subspecialty within medicine. Even before you start the career, you'll know what exactly to do.
Exactly.
Therefore, it is important, and all of those tools are very much practiced within your world of medicine at Aspirations. So that is the basic outline of what it takes to become a doctor.
Yes, I mean, and now each and every test, I have to ask you, Deepamala, is it done tailor-made for each student? Like as soon as a student comes in, each person, is it a different process depending on the person?
Yeah, I'll just let you know how it happens, because the senior management of Aspirations, and specifically Mrs. Daphne Abhesekar and Mr. Ajit Abhesekar, they have been counseling over the so many students. So they, when they are counseling, in that they have taken these personality tests into account by practice and the scientific methods, and they will be doing a personal counseling session which involves all the three circle strategies. Like, we might not specifically mention and say we are doing a three circle strategy, we are doing the information, vision, passion cycle, we are doing a personality test based on the Myers-Briggs, but a sort of a more like a 17 year of experience of counseling, mm-hmm. about like more than 15,000 students, mm-hmm. And that is in their blood to be able to judge and tell, mm-hmm. because sometimes for the students it will be a bit sort of strange if you say, okay, this is the circle, this is a circle, kind of that. Mm-hmm. So we take all these things into account when we are equipping our counselors, mm-hmm. also when we are training the counselors, so that they know to judge and get the right answer from the student and the parent and give them the right choice. Mm-hmm. So all this research that our think tank at the Your World of Medicine at Aspirations is doing is passed on to the senior management and the counselors, okay. who in turn take the experience also, put it together and do the counseling sessions. Mm-hmm. So I think as a result, there is a lot of word of mouth created, and many students and parents come to us, and we are very happy to give them the service, and our service is absolutely free of charge. So at this crucial juncture, when the EZ course are going to come out and the A-level results are going to come out, we invite all the A-level students and the parents also to come visit us, and especially for the medical students and well as the other students as well. And let me just give you one more opportunity for everybody who is interested in engineering now. We have a very two special scholarships to the RMIT Vietnam campus. Okay. It's 50% off for two students who are going through Aspirations Education exclusively. So we have two scholarships for the October intake. This is for the engineering students. So that's again another opportunity. And I think what Aspirations is trying to do is a lot of research based, mm-hmm. on the career guidance and placement to give the best possible
and
service.
And I think you should give out maybe the contact details.
Definitely,
that,
yeah.
That they can find out more information,
yeah.
as well.
Let me tell you the hotline number, which is 0777-539-888. And of course, our website, which is www.aspirations.edu.lk. And you can log on to our Facebook page, which is Aspirations Education as well. And there's going to be a new Facebook page on the Aspirations Education Foundation, our social duty arm. So we will keep you posted, and we're going to have an open day, especially for Manipal University, Melaka Manipal, 2 years in India, 2 years in Malaysia for medicine studies. And the open day will be somewhere in August, around August 22nd or so. Mm-hmm. The exact dates would be posted on our website and the Facebook pages. So be in touch with us. People from University of Manipal will be coming down, the admission office as well. So if you have your results ready and even pending results, we can focus on the October intake and also the April intake as well.
All right. So I think that we've given out a lot of valuable information and a lot of food for thought this morning when it comes to the future of your child, if you're a parent, or your own future, if you're a student. So thank you so much, Ms. Deepamala, as well as Dr. Indubar, for being with us on the show.
One small message I want to give as the last message.
Of course.
That is, I would make this an opportunity to invite all the A-level students. This is a service given free of charge, and we don't charge anything for this service. So make use of this opportunity, mm-hmm. to select a career in if you are planning to go into a career in medicine.